Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, I'm Nurani and I'm a student from English Education Department of State Islamic University of Alauddin Makassar. And I'm in the second semester. So, in this video, I'm going to share tips and tricks of sounding more like American. And I realized that when I'm speaking English, it's not like English, but the sound is like Indonesian. So I think it's so weird, and I realized that I needed to work on my accent and on my speech to be more like a natural American person. So in this video, I'm going to share exactly what I've done and think it can help me to sounding more like a natural American. And for your information, I made this video for my assignment, Phonetics and Phonology assignment. And this assignment was given by my lecturer, Mr. Andi, Kaharuddin, S.IP. So, if you're interested, please continue watching this video. The first thing that is really helpful is understanding the word that Americans are using when they're trying to think of something, when they're trying to find the right word for the purse. And these words are like and amp. So, for example, when somebody asks me what I do and I'm not really sure how to describe, I say, I'm an entrepreneur, like booking some platform for study abroad experiences. So we are using like instead of pauses to think of the next word of the phrase. And I think it's really helpful because sometimes I'm using just some random noises which make my speech so weird. So, every American using like, or you can keep silence but some little time, like, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm booking some platform for study abroad experiences. So, yeah, that is the first tips. The second thing is how Americans greet each other. So at school, we're told to say good morning, good evening, good afternoon. But in America, you would only hear these phrases if you're entering an office, if you're entering a restaurant or shop, or the person was reading this way. So this is pretty formal. And if you're making friends with American and you see them for the first time, so you will go like, what's up, bro? What's going on? Oh my god. So, if you want to sound like American and you see a friend, you will be like, what's up, bro? What's going on? And if you're a green girl, you will be like, oh my god, what are you doing? So good to see you. So, yeah, just like that. And so, the way to answer this question is not go into details about your personal life and about things that have happened to you in the past few days. But the best answer here is like, I'm good, what about you, what have you been up to? So just ask them some question, and there's no need to, you know, like start a 5-minute speech about what happened in your life. The third thing that Americans really like is praise. Oh my god, like when something amazing happens, you're ripped this way. Oh my god, like, oh really? So you're like so excited for the person. And also, oh my god is also used when something is really funny. So when you're texting someone, you can always use the construction OMG and say oh my god, and you can use LOL, and I think LOL is pretty common, right? The fourth thing is another way to express your astonishment about somebody's accomplishment or a next level or whatever. It's like, hey, I'm going to spend 3 weeks in Korea. So the person would ask me like, really? Seriously? As if I was lying, as if I'm lying all the time. But this is what they do. So they just ask you again, they want you to confirm you're actually traveling to Korea. And so they say really and seriously, and you would be like, yeah, you can imagine that? Can you imagine that? spent 3 weeks in Korea, spent our holiday in Korea, and like blah blah blah. So using this really and seriously would really encourage another person to tell you more about what they're bragging about. And the last thing is, do you know the word? Yes. When something happened to you that you are so really really upset, make you so crazy, driving you so crazy, and you don't want to say shit in public, so you would say shit. Like, oh my god, oh shit. So saying shit instead of shit is something that also American. The best way to practice all of that is talking to yourself. It's a great way. And you just can try and try and be an actor, be a singer, and be somebody who copies everyone. And remember that don't use all of that in a formal way, and don't use all of that if you're talking to your mother, to your father, to your parents, to your lecturer, to your teacher. So just remember that don't use all of that in a formal way. I think that's all about my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe our YouTube channel. And thank you for watching. Have a great day. Hope you enjoy it. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Driving you so crazy, and so you don't want to say in public, so you would say, oh shit, like that.